object oriented. In Python, everything is an object, right? Now let's see an example. What everything is an object? Yes. Now suppose I'm giving a equal to 10 and then b equal to 4, right? And then I'm giving the object like a plus b. I mean, c equal to a plus b. Right? What is an output? A equal to 10 and equal to b equal to 4 and then a equal to c equal to a plus b, right? Now, what is happening in a sense? A is a value and then a is a value consists of 10, right? But here the a is an object, right? Here the a is object here. Now, what? Sorry, a is an object, right? What is mean by an object? Means object is an entity which holds the memory. Object is entity which holds the memory. Clear? Now let's see an example. A equal to 10, right? A equal to 10. Now the A creates an empty object. The A creates an empty object which holds 10, which holds the value 10, and then a is a variable which refers a particular object location. Means the A consists of only the reference of an object. Clear? Now what is everything in as an object? Means in Python, what happened? In Python, no data type, right? No declaration part, and then it dynamically allocates a memory. How many bytes is required for a particular memory location? But not on the variable, it's on the object only. That object consists of only values. It allocates the memory for only values. Is it clear? Now let's see an example. A equal to 10 and then b equal to something, right? And then c equal to a plus b. Let us execute that. A equal to 10, b equal to 4, and then c equal to a plus b. Now I want to print c. Want to print c. Okay, what is the answer? Answer is a 14, right? Now, but what happens here? Let us see the idea of a and idea of b, right? And then if you take the b equal to 10 also, the id remains same. Why? Because it's an immutable elements, means it will not change. When you change the element values, but the id remains same, is called immutable. We can't change the id of a particular value. Now the value is 14, right? Now I am doing that. I want to create one more thing. The same time, a equal to 10 I have given already. Now b equal to, again I am giving 10, right? Let's print. Print type of a and print type of b. Let's see an output, right? What is the type? Type is a integer type of elements, both are. Now I want to check it. What is the id? Print int of a, sorry, id of a, and then print id of b. Now let's check what is an output. Yes, the id remains same. Right, you can see, right here the id remains same. You are getting for id of a and the id of b. What is the value of a? A value is 10 and then b value is 10. The id remains same, means that the value creates for 10. The value creates for 10. It refers the values like a and b, right? It's a, b. A, b values both are refers only one object, right? That's why it is an complete object oriented programming language. Got it? But you know, the remaining languages are what is that? And then Java is a pure, no, it's not a pure object oriented. And then Python is not also not a pure object oriented programming language. It's an complete object oriented programming language, not pure. Right? Remember this? Right. Next, what are the versions present in Python? Actually, the versions in the sense, what are the different increments of a behavior or otherwise implementation of some built-in functions or libraries or other else. But based on that, we will decide that 2.x and 3.x, two versions of Python versions. And 2.x, what is 2.x and 3.x? What is the difference, main difference? The first one is in print. First one is in print. Means that in print, what happened? In 2.x, we will write print like print space. We will write like this in 2.x. Right? The same thing in 3.x, print of, we will write like this. What is the difference in the sense? In 3.x, we embed the C type structure in print statement. Nothing else is different, right? The next one is range. Range is the main difference. The Python 2.x uses X range. Uses X range. X range in the sense it takes the raw data. It takes the raw data. At the same time, here we are using the range. Here we are using only range. That is the only difference. And then in 3.x, only one division operator is there. The result is float. It does result is float. At the same point of time, in 3.x, double division operator, it is an integer division. Integer division. Right? Now, one more difference is, in 3.x, we included that future module. Future module. What is future module actually? Why? Because you are all the pressures. You are going, for example, you selected for a particular company, right? And then what happened? They already built some applications. You are newly entering it. They already built some applications in older versions, but you know only the higher version of Python. Then what happened? By using future module, you can run your program or your module or your project in both as well as a 2.x and 3.x. Got it or not? Right. The next one is Unicode, UTF. What is Unicode literals? Means by Unicode literal in the sense, for example, if you want to write a language, for example, you want to write a Python code in Telugu. Otherwise, if you want to write in Python code in some other language. Otherwise, you need to execute a particular functionality in embedded format. You can use a UTF. Am I clear? Right. This is the major difference between the 2.x and 3.x. And then we all know that it has some additional functionalities. Right? Additional functionalities. What additional functionalities? Okay, we can develop from 2.x, we can write a limited number of functions. You can limited number of built-in functions. Right? In 3.x, some other additional functions. Right? That is only difference. And then you need to know one more point here. If you know the exact class name of a variable or otherwise exact class of a particular members, then you can able to get all the built-in methods or user-defined methods. Otherwise, you can pass a method, right? By using your directory. By using directory. It is very important one. Why you are using a directory? Why? Because, for example, if you take a list, list has so many built-in functions, right? But you can't able to remember all those built-in functions in single, why? Because our mind is very small, right? So we can't able to remember all those things. So, for remembering what are the built-in functions present in a particular class, right? For that purpose, we can use that dir method. right? We can use the dir method. Now, how we can use it? For example, a equal to morning we learned how to declare a list. That is, I am declaring a list, right? Now, I want to know what is the type. Type of A, right? Type of A, right? And then type, I want to know what are the built-in methods present in a particular list, right? Let us explain. Print of its dir of A. Let's see what is an output. Right. What is the type? Type is a list. Right. List is the type. And then what are the built-in methods? Right. Here double underscore add. Right. You can see that. Double underscore add and then class contains all together. Right. These and all a built-in functions. These and all a built-in functions. Here you see that append, clear, copy, count, extend, index, insert, and pop remove. These and all user defined functions. But user defined and sender, those are also built in functions. But you can able to extend to the next level. Why? Because you can use it and you can pass the parameter to use a particular method. Clear? Now, this is about the directory. And the next one, we all know this. What is the flow of executing a program in Python? Why? Because it's an of course it's an interpreted programming language, right? It's an interpreted programming language, and then it executes sequence by sequence. Sequence by sequence. What is sequence by sequence actually? Means, for example, you have a 10 lines of code, right? You have a 10 lines of code or some lines of code, right? It executes like this, like downwards. Why? Because it executes the first statement. If first statement has no errors, it go to second statement and then third and fourth and next one, right? At the same point of time, if you want to break a flow of execution, if you want to break a flow of execution, you can use a control flow statement. The name itself called control flow of statement. It's the statements which can control a flow of executing a statement. A sequence of executing a statements you can control by using these statements. Now let us see what are the different types of control statements present. Right now, okay. Right. Let us see what are the different control flow statements. The control flow statements are likely a conditional statement. The first one is a conditional statement, and the second one is looping statements, and the third one is jump statements. Control flow statements. The control flow statements are, the first one is conditional. What are the different conditionals present? That is, the first one is if, the second one if else, the third one is if else. We can use both, but in Python program, we can't use switch cases. We can't use the switch cases. So for the switch cases, you can use a different methods by using if else only, right? The second one is looping statements. The second one is the looping statements. What are the different looping statements present? Right. Let us see that. First one is while loop. The first one is while loop. And then the second one is for loop. Only two loops present. One is a while loop and then for loop. But here the for loop is not the same as a C, but its syntax is different. Let's see further. Right. Now the next one is the third one is jumping statements. Next one is a jumping statement. So what is the jumping statements present? Break, continue, and then pass. Right? These are the jumping statements present in Python. Right. Now let's see. Right. First we will see that if conditional statement. First one is, let's say if condition. What will happen? What is the syntax? If condition statements, if condition and then state. Right. Now let's see an example. I'm giving if 10 is greater than 20. 10 is greater than 20. Right. 10 is greater than 20. Is it right? No. Now I'm printing 10 is big. Right. 10 is big. I'm writing. Let's print. Right, nothing is printed. Why? Because that 10 is not greater than 20. What's happened here? Let's see. Right, here the 10 is greater than 20. The condition is false. The condition is false. It holds the sequence of flow. It holds the sequence of flow of execution of a particular statement by the condition, by only the condition. If the condition is passes, I mean the condition is true, then only executes these statements, which is in the if statements, right? Otherwise it will come out of the condition and then it executes the flow of statements, right? Now the condition is false here, it comes out. I didn't write anything now, so it does not print anything. Right, let us check. Print hello. I'm just writing print hello. It prints only hello, but not 10 is big. Why? Because the condition is false here. Now let us write less than. 10 is less than 20. Here the condition is true, then what happened? 10 is big and then hello is printing. Why? Because whenever the condition is true, it goes inside the if loop, I mean if condition, then it executes all the statements, then come out and then execute outer statements. Clear? That is the if condition. That is simple if. Now let us see else if condition. How the else if is work. Else if. Right. Now what is the syntax? Let us write a direct program. If same program I am taking, 10 is greater than 20. Is it right? No. It executes the true block. It is a true block. It's a true block. In true block I am giving print 10 is big. Right? If true block is present, we have to write a false block also. Right or not? Now I am giving the false block here in the else block. Now, the false black, right? Print 20 is big. 20 is big. Come out. I am printing something out of condition. Sorry, out of condition, right? Now let us execute this. See, if the statement is true, right? If the statement is, this statement is true, it goes inside and then it executes this. It's a true block if this statement is true. Otherwise, if this statement is false, then what happened? It goes to else block and then it executes what the statement present in else. Right? Here the 10 is greater than 20, the condition is false, then it goes to else statements and then it executes the statement inside the else and then it prints the 20 is big. Now, if the condition statement is executed, it come out from the loop, right? It come out from the conditional statements and then it prints the out of condition. Clear? It is if else statements. Now, let one more thing is if else. I mean else if statements. What is else if statements? If I want to compare a three operators, for example, I want to compare between the A and B and C. Otherwise, I want to make that if you guys are greater than 18, you are present for vote. Otherwise, less than 75, right? You are not eligible for something like a pension, right? So let's see. This one is else if statements. Else if statements means that in false black you are giving again a condition. In false block, again, you are giving condition. Clear? Okay, let us check how it will work. Right. For example, if condition, the same thing, 10 is greater than 20 and is an operator which is used as a comparator. I mean, it maintains a comparison between the two different statements, right? And 10 is greater than 30. 10 is greater than 30, then print 10 is big. Right? And then now 10 is not big, right? Now else if, here the else if is ELIF is the syntax, right? Else if the condition is 20 is greater than 10 and 20 is greater than 30. Print 20 is big. Else print 30 is big. Let's take a small example. Right? Here what happened? If 10 is greater than 20, 10 is greater than 20? No, the condition is false. Here, if the first condition is false, then it won't go to the next statements to execute or next statement to check. Why? Because the AND operator consists, if only one statement is false, then all the statement is false. Okay. Then it go to next one. It will check here. The condition is true. No, it's false. Sorry. The condition is true here. Why? Because 20 is greater than 10. The next statement, it's false. What is the result? True and false. It's a false. True and false is false, right? Now, if the condition is false, then it go to the false black. Else, then it prints the statements, right? Before understanding this, you need to know about AND OR logics. What are the AND OR logics? Let me explain simply. Right? Statement one. Statement two, result. One, and if you perform two operations, then it becomes true. Right? It is AND operator. OR operator in the sense, anyone is true, then it's true. Anyone is true, it's true. Zero, one, the result is one. When it comes zero, two zeros is there, then it's zero. Means two false operations performed in condition, then it's zero. It is for OR statements. It's for AND statement. Clear? Now, the next one is how you can use the if-else statement as switch cases. What is a switch case actually? Switch case in the sense you have one choice. For example, the weekdays is 1 to 7 weekdays. If I press 5, then it displays Thursday, right? When I press 5, it displays Thursday or Friday. When I press 0, it displays Sunday, right? Like the programs you want to write. Then here no switch cases is there. Else if you can write, but the program length is very high, so you can use a simple structure. Right. Now the same program I'm writing, A is B, A is greater than B. The same program I am writing in different ways. For example, I'm giving A equal to 45 and then B equal to 60. If A is greater than B, then print A comma A is big. Right? A is big, I'm writing. Else, print, sorry, B is right? Now this program I want to write in different ways. Means, for example, print indentation problem. Okay, print A, if A is greater than B, the else B is bigger. Right? The beauty of Python is you can write a code in a single line. It's a comprehension, right? The single line of code conversion is called a comprehension, right? So this bigger program I wrote in only single line. Let me execute. What is the value of A? A equal to 45, B equal to 60. The A is greater than B. No, it's false. It go to else statements. Now the B is big, right? Here, let's see what is an output. See here. 60 is big. Okay. For this 60 is big, it's printed. For this one, B is bigger, it printed. Clear? Now, the one more thing also you can write one more way. Print of B comma A बूलियन ऑफ ए इज ग्रेटर देन बी, राइट, ए इज ग्रेटर देन बी कमा इज बिग, फॉर दिस वन आई एम गिविंग बिग, लेट एग्जीक्यूट, यस 60 इज बिगर. हियर व्हाट हैपन, ए इज अ वेरिएबल, राइट, इफ ए इज ग्रेटर देन थ्री ए इज बिगर, दिस कंडीशन इज फॉल्स, इट गो टू एल स्टेटमेंट्स, बी इज बिगर, फाइन, बट हियर सर अनिल सर somebody is turn on mic. Please mute yourself if anybody turn on mic. Right. Here, print b comma a. I'm giving b comma a. What happened here? If boolean, boolean in a sense, it returned true or false. It returns. Let's see here. It returns a true or false. Right. Means a is greater than b. It's is it true? No, it's not true. So if it is true, it go to the second statement 0 1. This one is becomes 0. This one is becomes 1 in the boolean, right? The list is consists of starting from 0 and 1 indexes. The 0th index is b and the first index is a. So the return, it returns the value. If it returns the value 0, it executes b is bigger. If it returns value 1, it executes a is bigger. Clear? Right. Now, by using and or operator, how we can calculate a particular biggest number, biggest of 2. Right? Now, I am writing print. A is greater than b. And A or B. See here, let's print what is the output. 60 is the output. Right? 60 is the output. Why? Because it's a biggest number, biggest of 2 values. By using these statements also, you can write. Here what happened? A is greater than B. Is it true? False. And then A is having a value true, right? False and true. If the condition is false, it will not execute this one. It directly go to B and it prints. Why? Because the Python compiler calculates the AND statement. If the first statement is wrong, then it will not execute the second statement. It concludes that the AND statement is, if one statement is wrong, the full of statements is wrong. So here, the AND instance, this condition is false, so it comes directly out of this method, right? It comes to B and then it prints B. Clear? The OR in the sense, the total statements is false here. The OR, even one statement is right, then the whole statement is right. So it executes the second one also. So it contains the value 60. So it prints 60. Clear? These are the different ways to execute a particular method of program. Right. Now, let us execute how to write a particular choice of programs. Choice of program. See, I'm executing a choice here. If I enter choice 6, if I enter choice 6, I want to get a particular data belongs to a particular choice. So I'm giving options here. Options equal to, I'm using mapping functions. Just remember the syntax. We will discuss this about in later classes. One, and then two is map to, टू नाउ लेट्स प्रिंट ऑप्शंस डॉट गेट ऑफ चॉइस कमा इनवैलिड चॉइस कैन यू गेस व्हाट इज द आउटपुट राइट नाउ हियर आई गिव द चॉइस इज सिक्स द ऑप्शंस कंसिस्ट ऑफ ओनली वन एंड टू दैट द ऑप्शन इज नॉट देयर हियर सो इट इट डिस्प्लेस द इनवैलिड चॉइस ओके फाइन नो प्रॉब्लम बट here what is happening in the sense it gets option is a dictionary here it is a dictionary right option is a dictionary I am getting a choice if choice is present it prints the value of a particular choice otherwise it prints invalid choice clear now looping statements what are the different looping statements present in Python. Looping statements. Okay, we will execute the first while loop. Right? What is looping statements? Looping statements in the sense, for example, I want to execute this print statements 10 times. So in earlier, what happened? You need to write 10 times a same particular code. Right? That means that you are wasting a memory and then it will take so much of time to execute a particular. Why? Because Python is an interpreter language. It executes line by line. Each and every line is takes as a command. So that command is present or not, it has to check to the compiler and then it comes back and gives a result. So it is having so much of burden in any compiler. So we created like looping statements. Why? Because if you want to execute a particular number of, a program statement in particular number of times, or otherwise you want to repeat a particular statement in number of times, you can use a looping statement. How? Let's say here. I want to print 1 to 5 numbers, only just 1 to 5 numbers. What is the program? While, okay, I am giving that I. I is nothing but iterative variable. I am giving ITR. ITR is greater than or equal to 5. Then print of ITR. Right? And then ITR plus equal to 1. This statement is equal to ITR equal to ITR plus 1. Okay, remember this. Before that, I want to declare ITR equal to 1. Right? Let us execute. Right here I gave 1 2 3 4 5 numbers. Right here if you want to print these 5 numbers what happened print of 1 right you can you are writing like this print of 1 and then print of 2 To remove the code complexity, you can use the looping statements for easy to use and easy to repeat a particular statement. here what we are doing. Let's see. Right, here ITR I am initializing as 1, right? ITR I am initializing as 1, right? Now here the ITR 1 is less than 5. Okay, true. Then if the condition is true in while loop, if condition is true, it executes the statements present in while loop, and then it again pointing the loop statement if the iterative is present. If iterative is not present, I mean if increment is not present, then it this loop executes continuously. It raises the exception. Clear? Now let's see. If the condition iterative is 1, the 1 is less than 5, the condition is true, it prints 1. It prints 1. The iterative is incremented as 2, right? 2 is less than or equal to 5, the condition is true, it prints 2, right? The iterative plus 1, that is 3. 3 is less than or equal to 5, yes, the condition is true, it prints 3. At the same time, it prints until 5. After 5, what happened? The condition, the iterative statement is 5. 5 plus equal to 1, that is, it becomes 6. 6, right? 6 is not less, 6 is less than or equal to, less than 5? No. It is equal to 5? No. The condition is false. It come out of the loop. Clear? Now, this is while loop. While loop syntax in a sense, while, condition, and then your statements, and then increment or decrement. Increment or decrement. Now, we will see next loop statement. For. Here in Python, the for loop is somewhat different from other languages. If you know the PHP or some other language, the for each is there. So the syntax is like that. The syntax is for iterative variable in particular range or list of values or string. We can use anything, and then statements. Right? Here, no increment and decrement operator is present. Why? Because the iterative starts from 0 and then it iterates plus 1. Clear? Now, let us write a program for I in SVP set. Let's take a SVP set. Right. Let us print I. Print I. See, let's see the output. Yes. See here, the output is a SVP set, but each and every character prints in a separate line. But remember, in Infosys or any other computational exam for programming, you can use this only print for some cases. For example, if you want to print 1, 2, 3, 4 as a serial numbers, otherwise names as an identity. So you can use only print. But you want to print as a whole string, otherwise a whole data, you have to use that end. You have to use end. End equal to, I'm giving like this. So it prints in single line. Yes, it prints in single line. Here, what is end? एंड इन द सेंस इन प्रिंटिंग एवरी स्टेटमेंट आई वॉन्ट टू गिव ए स्पेस बिटवीन वर्ड्स, स्पेस बिटवीन द वर्ड्स मीन्स ईच एंड एवरी कैरेक्टर आई वॉन्ट टू एंड विथ ए स्पेस एंड देन कंटिन्यू विथ यूर इटरेटिव ऑपरेटर अगेन. Then it again go to here and then it plus 1, it takes v and then it v comes here, then end what happens, already you have a space, already you have some data, you are appending this I to previous one, I mean I in a sense I consists of value v now, clear? That is end. End in the sense just it ends with a character, it ends with a character. For example, I want to put a character like this one in end, then what happened? Now you will understand what is end. See here, at the end of every character you are printing this one, printing this one, what are the parameter you are passing? Actually this is a keyword argument, right? Print is a method and then this is a keyword argument. Then next further classes we will see about this, right? Just remember how to write it, right? The next one. Now let execute one simple program using for loop. I want to print a particular name in rotational wise, a particular name in rotational wise. For example, I'm taking the input is like SVPCET. Let's write this one only, SVPCET, and then I want the output like rotation. It is very important in InfyTQ exams. Why? Because the rotational and splitting is very important. Just see that how to do it. Right now I want output like SVPCET space VPCETS space PCETSV, right? Space next CETSVP space ET SVPC space and then T SVPCE. I want output like this. Let's write code for this program. So I'm simply write simply I'm taking that input. I'm taking input. Remember that while writing a coding, here the Python is no data types is there. For a simple programs I am not using any norms for to write identifiers, but if you are writing a main projects or major projects in companies, you have to mention that you have to follow some norms. What is that norm? Let's see. I am declaring the integer variable int a, like this you can write. Now I am taking that string, right? Str string underscore name, string underscore name. I'm giving name here SVPCET. I'm taking SVPCET as an input. Now first I am printing this one, right? I'm printing this and then I want to rotate, right? For I in range of, I'm taking I don't know how much length this input is present. Here is only 5 to 6 letters you can identify easily, but in real time what happened, you can't able to identify how much big string the user has to give. So length of str underscore name, right? Now I equal to str underscore name of I2 plus str underscore name of colon I. I'm printing this one. Now I'm printing print I comma and equal to spaces. I'm giving like this. Let's see an output what it will come. See, it came output like this. See, I'm expecting output like this, right? Is it same? Right. Let's see how it will work. In the first iteration, what happened? Let's see. In the first iteration, now the I value is starts from zero. The I value starts from zero, and then zero colon. Okay, zero colon. Zero colon in the sense it starts from zero, right? It starts from zero means S is a zero now. S is a zero is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. S is 0. Now 0 consists of S. From S to every element it prints. Right? Every element it prints. See here. 0 and then colon. I'm not giving anything here. I'm not giving anything. Means 0 to end. It means that 0 to end of a string. This is for end. We are not mentioning anything, it goes to end. Okay, here the string is SVPCET, right? Now plus is for concatenate here. Now colon zero. Okay, colon zero. Colon zero is null. Why? Because I'm not mentioning any first point. I'm not mentioning any first point here. Okay, zero. Zero in the sense it is a zero, right? Zero to zero. It's a null. So it prints SVP set as it is. Why? Because SVP set plus null, SVP set only. Let's take second one. One colon. If you give one colon, what is one here? Zero is yes. Zero is yes, and then one is V. So here the thing is VPCET it will take. VPCET. 1 to end, that is VPCET, that is plus, right? We are taking that colon. We are taking colon 1, right? Colon 1. Colon 1 in the sense, the before that what elements is present? That is S. That is yes. We are concatenate both. That is VPCET plus 1. VPCET plus yes. VPCET plus yes. Okay. The next one is 2 colon. 2 colon in the sense, what is 2? 0. 0 is yes. 1 is V. And then P is 2, right? That is 2. I mean P. PCET it will print. Plus, what is this? Colon 2. Colon 2 in the sense, what is the output? Yes and V. Why? Because it not starting position, it takes 2. 2 in the sense 0, 1, it's 2. Okay, when you give 2 here, it takes minus 1, that is 1 position only. Okay, so it prints yes, V. If you concatenate both, PACET and yes, V. Like this, remaining things will happen. Clear? Okay, any doubts regarding for loop and then what are the concepts we are discussed now? Hello guys, any doubts? Or otherwise I can go further. We are open to clarify your doubts. If you have doubts, post in chat window. Okay, fine. The next concept is morning we discussed about list, right? Now, what is mean by a list? Let us revise one. What is mean by a list? List is nothing but it's a sequence of characters. It's a sequence of not sequence of characters. It's a sequence of words or sequence of data. We are storing sequence of data. We are storing a sequence of data in a list. What type of data you are storing? For example, if you consider an array, it stores only homogeneous data elements. But here we can store heterogeneous data elements. Heterogeneous data we can store here, right? Let's see how to define a list. A equal to, I am defining list, the type of A equal to list only. But I want to access the particular list. How you can access particular list? You have so many methods, built-in functions. Let us see. Print of dir of A. So we already see that. Let's check once again. See here we have so many methods, but these methods are used for basically for instance classes. I mean instance methods, but here we are mainly use this method, right? Let us check one by one. What is happened? A equal to, I am giving empty list here. I don't have any value A, right? Okay, I'll execute in this, right? I'm giving the empty here. So the A consists of nothing here. But I want to add a particular element to A. I want to add a particular element to A. Why? Because A is consists of empty. It don't have any value because it has a null value. So I want to append a data. I want to add a data at the last of a list. Means it has already a data. It has already data that is null. I want to append a data. So if you have null data, it will replace the null into a particular value. Let's see. A dot append of, I'm giving the value like 10, right? And then A dot append, I'm giving value 20. And A dot append, I'm giving value 30. And A dot append, I mean giving value 50 here. See, let's print what is the output of list. Right? What is the output of list? 10, 20, 30, 50. So the append function, it is used to add a data at the end of your list. Add the data at the end of your list. You can give any of the data. Let's check A dot append. I mean giving the value like Tom. Sorry. I'm giving value like Tom. Let's A. Right? A equal to 10, 20, 30 and Tom. Why? Because the list can store able to store different types of data. Different types of data, that is heterogeneous data elements. It's a collection of heterogeneous data elements. Right. Now, what is the difference between append and insert? Now, insert contains two parameters. One is index and then second one is an object. One is index and second one is object. What is index value here? So, for example, here 10, 20, 30, 50 and Tom is there, right? But I forgot to insert 40 in a sequence. So, I want to insert in particular position. Here what happened? Let's see, it's a 0, it's 0, this one 1, this one second index, this one third index, this one fourth index, basically. So I want to insert a 40 in third index, 40 in third index. These indexes are shift right at 1, shift right at 1. So I'm giving the index position 3. I'm adding a data 40. Let's see 10, 20, 30, 40, and then 50. Fine. What is the next one? Index is sorry. Right. Insert is completed. Now I want to get a particular index value, index to a particular value. For example, I want to know the which position Tom is present. I want to know the which position the Tom is present. Let's do like a dot index of, here you need to give the value. You need to give the value index of Tom, right? Here it prints 5, means this first 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements is there. 6 minus 1, this is fifth element. Its index starts from 0, right? The fifth element is Tom, right? Now I want to find out the length of data, length of whole data. So len of A, the length of A is 6. The length of A is 6. Clear? Now okay. Now the next one is, if you have a different types of data, if you have a different types of data, I mean different types of data, then how you can sort the element, how you can sort the element. But here in Python 3, you can't able to sort if you have a heterogeneous data. If you have only the homogeneous data elements, you can able to solve it. Let's check it. A dot sort. A dot sort. Here it gives an error. It gives an error message. What is that error? You can see it. The less than operator, it's not supported between the string and int. Why? Because in sorting each and every operator, you need to compare that. You need to shift right or left according to your record, your requirement, right? So we can't able to compare the string and int. So it gives an error. If you have is that homogeneous data, that is 20, 30, 10, 25, something like this. Now b dot sort, b dot sort. Now prints b, it gives sorted elements. Why? Because if you have a homogeneous data elements in list, you can able to sort the list. If you have a heterogeneous data, you can't able to sort, right? At the same point of time, here the b value is changed completely. Why? Because the b value is this one. B value is 20, 20, 10, 25. But now the B value is 10, 20, 20, 25. Why? Because it converted, I mean, it sorted permanently. So in some programs, I don't want to sort permanently. I don't want to sort permanently. Then you can give B dot sorted. B dot sorted. See here. Okay, sorry, I did a mistake. Sorted of B. Sorted of B. Here, let's see, the sorted list came, but the B value is not changed. B value is not changed. If you want to do permanently the sort, if you want to permanently to do sorting, then you can go with this. You can go with this. And then you want temporarily, you can go with this method. It's your wish, right? Now what is reverse of a particular list? What is reverse of a particular list? Reverse in the sense, if you have a particular set of list, you can able to reverse it. For example, here I have the elements like already sorted elements I have. A, I don't have a sorted elements. Why? Because A give A have a heterogeneous data, right? The B have a already sorted elements, but I want to reverse a particular list. So B dot reverse. B dot reverse. I'm printing B. It reverse. The list is reversed. Okay. Here the B consists of two data. I mean two common data. But I want to know how many common data is present in a particular list. We can use a count. We can use count. Let's see. I want to count. I want to count how many times the 20 is present. How many times the 20 is present? It displays 2. Displays 2. Clear? How many times the data is present? It displays 2. Right? Now, how to delete a particular element from the list? How to delete a particular element from the list? Actually, you know, delete is an operator we can able to delete in a keyboard, right? But here also same thing. But here we can use like pop. For example, b dot pop. I'm giving b dot pop. It extracts the last value. It extracts the last value of b. Now the list becomes 25, 10, and 20. If I want to delete a list, I mean, I want to delete a variable, I want to delete a data at a particular index, then b dot pop of, I want to delete 0, 1, first index value, then b is deleted. Now the list is 25 and 20. Clear? Now these are the main methods present in list. Okay, clear? All of you clear how to access a list and how can you extract a data from list? Now let's write a program. I want to get a data. I want to get a data from a list. I want to get a data from list. Let's see. Let's write some operators. Some programs regarding list. I want to identify a common character between two strings. I want to identify common characters present in list two strings. Right, let's write a program. I want to write a string one Infosys training program, right? And then string two equal to very good in English. Okay, let us consider two strings, for example. So the result, I want to get a result. I want to get a result as a list. I want to get a result in list only. Okay, for that one, I'm storing a result. Yes, result. List, right? Now for I in str one, for I in, sorry, it's a disturbance one. Yes, for I in str one, I in the sense I is a iterative variables. It refers each and every character present in str. I in str, I in the sense here in is a in is an operator. In is a membership operator. Actually, I is a member of str. Yes, but here in performs in if condition, in performs in different actions, and for condition in performs in different actions. Why? Because if condition, if a particular member is present in group of elements, that is in if condition. But for, it searches each and every element present in group of elements present in the certain cluster, certain string. So I contains all of variables present in string one. Otherwise, if you mention here list, all data present in I only. If you repeat, I mean, if you iterate, right? If let's see I in str two. Let's see here in is different. Here in is different. Here in is for rotating. I mean repeating and getting elements. Here in is for membership. Membership means here I value is present here or not. Okay, right. Next one is result. Result dot append. Append of I am giving. Why I am giving now print. Print of res. Let's see command. It will print or not? No, it gives an error. Why? Because I am giving the result as a string. Now it will print. See, these are the common characters present in both strings. These are the common characters present in both strings. Here n is there. Here n is there, right? O O. Fine. The same program you can write in different way also. In same program you can write in different way. In only single line. Let's see what is that single line. RESUL result equal to x for in str one if x in str two or have results. I am printing just result. Okay. Sorry, I forgot to give iterative operator. Yes. Did you see the difference? No difference. Both are same strings. Why? Because here for x in str, if x in str means. Now is audible. Thank you. Yes. Here, they gave the input like this, alphanumeric characters, right? Here, the strings is sorry, the output is integers, right? How the integers output? Why? Because you can, first you have to slice a particular question. They give what type of question, whatever it may be, but you have to slice the questions in different pieces. So let I tell you how you can slice it. Right here it is a string, right? Here 5 is there, 8 is there, 7, 2, 3, 6. Yeah.
हेलो, प्लीज म्यूट यूर सेल्फ।
Here 5, 8, 7, 2, 3, 6, 9. These are the integers they give, right? These are the characters. These are special characters. Okay. Now, the output consists of whatever the integers they are given, same output is there, but in different order. But in different order, right? Now let's see. The 5 is an integer. Right here they give clearly why, because the number of special characters in a given string is even, it prints the even number, it prints the so it prints odd digits, it prints odd digits. If you have odd string, odd special characters is there, then you print even digits, you print even digits. Here ASP before 5, how many number of special characters? That is 0, right? That is 0. So it takes 5, it takes 5, and then here the W, then let's see, 8, sorry, at is a 1, exclamatory mark is 1, and then our pipe symbol is 1. 3 special characters is in a particular string. Clear? In particular string, we have 3 special characters. The sum of special characters, how many special characters is there? Only 3. So it prints first the odd digits. Sorry, even digits. It prints first even digits. So here again you come first, and then let's see, first is an, it's an odd number, it's an even number, so it shifted first, it prints 8, and then it prints 5, and then again it's some gap is there, so again it's an odd number, it's an even number, right? So it shifts 2, 7, and then again it will come, 6 is there, and then 3 is there, 3 is an odd number, so it shifts first, and then 6, 3, 9, 6, 3, 9. Let's see second example. These are the strings, I mean this is the string, right? So here 1, 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. Here also 3. One more is there, right? Okay. Sorry, I wrote question. I have given question is wrong. Okay, unless I'll change the question. Yes. Okay, the 1. See here. A number of special characters in a given string is even, so we should print the first digits and next odd digits. First even digits and odd digits means that a number of special characters in a given string is even. Is even. Here, how many special characters is there? It's an even. ASP they are giving, ASP in the sense it's no number is there, so it takes this one, and then it swaps A to 5. Clear? A 5 1 2 7 6 3 9. At the same point of time, let's see here 1 2 3, 4, right? Here 4, it's an even number, so it prints the odd number is first. It prints odd number is first. Same here 7, 8, 5, 6. Why? Because it have all the odd numbers, and then here 2. Okay. Here only one is there. Only one is there. That is 2. Next 6, and then here the 7 is comes first. Why the 7 is comes first means here we don't have any digits, any special characters. So it comes first, and then it prints output like this. So let's see a program, you can understand better way. So I am taking an input. Okay, let's copy this one. Yes, here what happened, n equal to input, I am taking an input, but here the input function is taking only strings, remember this. Okay, now here a equal to, I am taking empty list abc for the reference, and then I am taking some looping variables, and then for the conditions. Okay, from here the for I in n, for I in n, n in the sense n is a input to what I am giving, right? Let's trace it. Sorry, control is missed. Right, I in n in the sense it takes this variable iterator in each and every character, like is alpha numeric, I is alpha numeric, then f equal to 1, f is already initialized with 0, it becomes 1 now, right? It becomes 1. Wait, for you better understand, I want to make it as a new file. Okay, now let's solve it. Very good. Right, now this is the input, right? We have to give, right, for i in n in the sense n is this is the input, right? I is alpha numeric. What is I now? I is a zero now. I is 0, it takes a 0th index. Is it alphanumeric? No. So it goes to L, and then E equal to E plus 1. E becomes 1. E become 1. The next one is, and again, it iterating. S is alphanumeric? No. Now E becomes 2. P is alphanumeric? No. Then E becomes 3. Okay. 5 is alphanumeric. This is 5 is alphanumeric. Now the f become 1, and then w is alphanumeric, no, that is 4. So it iterates like this, and then finally you will get 1 2. The E is 7, and then F is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think it will become 10, I hope. Fine. Now, If the alpha numeric is there, then the event is incremented, and then is digit. If the number is digit, then it divide by 2. Why? Because you have to print, you have to divide a particular set of numerical data into even numbers and odd numbers. So you have to give like this int of I. Why? Because here you are giving everything is an string, so you have to convert this element into integer divided by 2 equal to 0. Now I want to append to the list is a equal to 2. A equal to 2. If even numbers is present in A list, and then odd numbers is present in B list. Okay, you got it. This is the logic. The next one is if E by 2, E in the sense the number of special characters, alphanumeric characters. This is the alphanumeric characters. Number of alphanumeric characters is divided by R equal to 0. Divided by R equal to 0. Let's see that 1, 2. No, right? So, 1, 2, 3. Only 3. Okay. 3 is mod 2 equal to 0. No, it's false. So, it goes to L. The length of A. The length of A. A consists of even numbers. So the even numbers it prints the first for the swap. This one is swap. Okay. Now the next one is if the length of B equal to length of A. Length of B equal to length of A is greater than length of B. Why? Because I'm giving two types of strings, one is for even and one is for odd. If length is greater than, then you can insert into the kth element. Kth element. I want to increase the kth element. I want to insert a particular kth index to the B. Kth index to the B. Right? Finally, for I in range of L. Here the L and remaining things are there is the here L is sorry. Here the L is nothing but the list of data which is present in particular numerical. So if the numerical range of data I want to insert that into C. Finally, what happened? I'm giving whole the B data. Why? Because B data consists of both A and B. Why? Because you are inserting here A values also. Right? You are inserting here the A values also into B. So, the B consists of both A and B. And then numerics A and B. Only the numbers. So, the M I am giving as empty now. Let's see. For I in C. C consists of list. C is consists of list here. Right? C consists of list. For I in C, I am increasing the str and then I am printing just m. Let's see what is C consists of. Just I am executing this. Sorry. See here. A3. The even number is first and then remaining is the odd numbers. Here. You know, you have to identify that in different test cases, you no need to worry about the outputs, what you are getting. But in Infosys exam, each and every test case you need to pass. Why? Because they are giving marks according to your test cases. How many test cases you are satisfying. So, if your condition is satisfied, then the test cases will pass automatically. Why? Because here, let's see here. The test case is here the numbers. If the number is odd, then it gets from even number to odd number. Okay, the condition is satisfied. So let's see what is C consists of. Just I am printing C here. Just I am printing. What C consists of? Okay, I am giving same output again. Sorry, I want to give here. Yes. See here. The C consists of a list, both A and B. The C consists of a list, both A and B. Just I am getting the list values here, right? Just I am concatenating with a list and string of list. Why? Because the everything is in a list. C consists of only string. We can't able to concatenate string and integer, right? So I am converting the integer to string and then I am concatenate, right? Let's see second program, right? These type of programs also very important. Why? Because you have to identify what is the logic behind it. You don't need to write the whole program also. If you write a whole program, it's very good, excellent. But if you can't able to do it, just you have to identify the logic and just write to satisfy a test cases which is present, which they give in examination, right? Now let's see here 930126. Here they give what we should divide the total number of strings into substrings. We should divide a total number of strings into substrings means we can divide each and everything, right? And we should verify each number is pronic number or not. If pronic, we should print that number. If you are getting a pronic number, then you can print that number. Otherwise, you no need to print, right? What is meant by pronic number actually? Pronic number in the sense the product of two consecutive numbers, right? For example, if you take 6, it is a product of two consecutive numbers, so the 6 is a pronic number, right? If you take 12, 3 into 4, two consecutive numbers. Consecutive number is in the sense the sequence of numbers, continuous numbers, right? So it's give 12, right? Clear. Now let's take input 12, 6 and something. Now sorry, this is the input. I want this one like output. Why? Because each and everything is a consecutive number or not. One is a consecutive number. Is one is consecutive number? No. Why? Because 1 into 2 or 0 into 1, 0. 1 into 2 is 1. 2. So it's not a pronic number. That 2. 2 in the sense 1 into 2. Right? 1 into 2. It's a consecutive number. Right? So it prints that. And then 6. Is 6 is a consecutive number? Yes. 6 is a consecutive number. 2 threes are 6. 2 threes are 6. It prints that number. And then you need to divide a string into substrings. Substrings in the sense you can divide a particular string into different combinations like 1 2 6 6 6 6 5 6 4 2 6 and something like that. Which is a pronic number, you have to print only the pronic numbers. Okay, let's see that. 12. It is also a substring, right? 12. 12 is nothing but 3 fours are 12. 3 fours are 12. And then what is 42? 6 sevens are 42, right? and then 650 as a product number. Clear? We need to display. First thing, we are dividing a string into substrings. Okay. Then, thus each and every substring is a product number. Then you have to print that number. Otherwise, just you ignore it. That is the program. Right? Let's see the program. See here. We are taking an input as it is. We are taking into A as a string. Why? Because we are taking a number as an input. We are converting A to string. Why? Because you have to divide this particular number into substrings. So you need to convert a number into string. So you are using str of A. Okay. I am getting a length of B. That is, I am storing into N. The length is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 is the length. Okay, N consists of 8. Okay, C I am taking for list. Why? Because you have to do a set of operations on a list. Why? Because if you convert into substrings, then you have to store into C. So I am defining C here. Okay, K and L for just to check the conditions, right? Let's see here. For I in range of N, the N consists of length 8. The range of N is nothing but 0 to 7. The range of N is 0 to 7. Right? Now, 0 to 7 is I consists of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? Now, I divided by 0. I double equal to 0. If I equal to 0, then this one is this loop is executing. Why? Because if I equal to 0, the only first condition is 0. The only first condition is 0. The remaining condition is not 0. So it goes to else spot. If I is not 0, so I am giving a range of n minus I. N minus I in the sense, for example, n is 8. N is 8 minus I. First thing is 0. Okay. For that, first one is 8. J is 8. Okay. C dot append. B of K to L plus 1. B of K to L plus 1. B is a string. B is a string. Okay. K to K in the sense. Here, the K value is 0. The K value is 0. 0 to, right? 0 to L plus 1. L equal to I they are giving. So, 0 plus 1, that is 1. 0 plus 1, that is 1. Here, let's see what is a 0 plus 1. It, 0 to 1. Here, let's see this example. 0 to 1. 0 is a 1 and then 2 is, 1 is 2. So, it takes that as a substring and then it appends to C. It appends to C. So, the C consists of all the substrings. All the substrings. Let's print C. One, two, double, six, 5042. I'm giving some number. See here. This particular string is divided into this many substrings, but I'm getting all these substrings, and then I'm just checking that two consecutive numbers are present or not by using this condition. The product of two consecutive numbers are possible or not by using this condition, and then just I'm printing this number I. Now, what D consists of? What D consists of here? D consists of nothing here, but it gets the sorted elements. It gets the sorted elements and then it repeats the sorted element values and then it checks consecutive number is present. For example, J is 1 and then J plus 1 is 2. 1 into 2 equal to I. I is the value of here. If, for example, I equal to 2, J, so J equal to 1 into 2. 1 into 2. J equal to 1. So J plus 1 is 2. and then equal to here the I value is 2. So it prints I value. It prints I value. Clear? It prints I value. At the same point of time, 6. 6 in a sense, here the value is 2. Right? This value is j plus 1, 3. So 2 into 3 equal to I. Means I the value, I next value. I value is 6. And then 2, 3 is a 6. So it prints 6. Like this, it will execute. Okay. I hope all of you guys are understood. Now, before winding up the session, I want to give an assignment. The first question, the assignment will open tomorrow morning 9 a.m. until 9 a.m. Tomorrow morning until 9 a.m. the assignment will open. Before that, you need to complete these 5 programs. Right? And then what you have to do is, you have to write a program in online GDB. Yesterday I sent how to do it a document in group. Just follow the instructions and then create online GDB and then write a program in online GDB. Just save it and then click on share. You can get a share code. Just copy that share code and then create a new Word document. Right? Create a new Word document and then write your roll number, name and email ID. Just day one assignments and then question number one, just print that link. Okay. Just print that link and then for all questions. Okay. One document you can give all 5 question answers as a link, not in a program, as a link you can give. Right. Now in 10 to 15 minutes, Kahoot quiz 2 will activate. Right. Please write the exam before 5:45. Okay, and then the same as it is upload in Canvas as a screenshot.